As you all must know by now, I'm no stranger to yachts. And if you've been keeping up with my videos, I'm sure you yourself have become fairly acquainted with the world's most luxurious recreational watercrafts. I've spent many a day soaking up the sun with the likes of Leo DiCaprio and Conor McGregor on some of the world's biggest and boldest floating vessels of cash. Today's video will continue in that vein as we take a look into the world's largest yacht, Dilbar. Famously known as the world's largest yacht by gross tonnage, or in simpler terms, interior volume, the 156-meter super mega yacht has redefined the notion of space in yachting. So, there may be some prideful yacht owners that claim their boat is bigger in size, but as far as interior space goes, nothing beats Dilbar. Frankly, no one has ever seen this much space in a yacht before. Most mega yachts serve as a suitable floating house, but Dilbar is more along the lines of a floating hotel. It's just massive, and it's the first yacht of this size, but it's not the first yacht by the name of Dilbar. It's actually the third yacht to bear the same name. Dilbar, as well as her predecessors, were delivered by Lursen, a luxury yacht manufacturer. All three of the Dilbar yachts were granted to her Russian billionaire owner by the name of Alisher Usmanov. The first Dilbar superyacht to be delivered to Alisher Usmanov, a billionaire investor whose net worth was valued at Forbes at $16 billion, was launched in 2005 by the Dutch shipyard. The first Dilbar was a significant step forward for the yacht, thanks to the 66 meters' innovative features, such as her spa pool and beach club, both of which were well ahead of their time. With an interior by Alberto Pinto, she became one of the most sought-after yachts on the water. Her rounded aft, as well as her impressive 1,801 gigatons of interior volume, made her stand out from the crowd on the exterior. Inside, amenities include a private cinema, spacious cabins on the main deck, a vast dining room, and a salon with a piano. Usmanov renamed the 66-meter to Ona in 2008, and subsequently put her on the brokerage market. The yacht was then sold in 2010 to U.S. oil mogul William Kellop at an asking price of 59.9 million euros. Her name was eventually changed again to Oceana, but alas, it was not long until the Russian billionaire received the new and improved Dilbar. Usmanov's second beauty became a 110-meter super yacht made out of Germany. She was launched by Lursen in June 2008 and became the 17th largest yacht in the world. In addition to this, she also became one of the first yachts on the water to have particle filters on her main engine exhausts. Known throughout her build as Project Opal, the 110-meter featured some similarities in interior design and amenities with the first Dilbar. A large jacuzzi with a glass wall and water feature was installed forward of the sun deck with a lounging area around it, just like that found on the original Dilbar. A lounge with a bar and piano was also incorporated into both yachts, as well as a private cinema. The scale of the new superyacht, however, allowed for a lot of new features. After all, the new Dilbar was nearly twice the length of its older sister. Upgraded features came with the new mega yacht, such as a large owner's office with several meeting areas and lounging area that opens up onto the upper aft deck. A separate executive conference room was also built on board, with an unbeatable view onto the sea through floor-to-ceiling windows. Other improvements include a spacious gym and a spa area. After several years near the top of the list of the world's largest yachts, the Dilbar name leapfrogged onto the number one spot with the delivery of the 156-meter behemoth that is now the fleet's flagship. One of yachting's most anticipated projects ever, Dilbar was launched in 2016 and boasted a gross tonnage of 15,917, confirmed by the shipyard. Around that same time, the 110-meter was renamed from Dilbar to Onya and put on the brokerage market, according to landing pages that have then sprung up on the websites of superyacht brokers. These have since been taken offline. However, it would seem by all accounts that Onya never changes ownership, meaning Usmanov is the lucky owner of both of these massive yachts. With an exterior design by Espen Oino, Dilbar now has a gross tonnage of 15,917 tons, hence topping Al Said's 15,850 tons and Azam's 13,136 tons. Notably, all three of these voluminous yachts were built by Lursen, that has kept fortifying its position as the main main destination for mega yacht construction. It's thanks to these three masterpieces that Lursen is now the name in super yachts. The Dutch shipyard and baller Russian billionaire certainly made their mark on the seas with their extravagant winning streak in the yacht world. Some impressive facts about the new Dilbar flagship include her beam of 23 meters as well as her deep 6-meter draft. On board, over 1,100 kilometers of cables were stretched for all the required wiring and setup. According to the shipyard, 3,800 square meters of living space were built on board the Dilbar. Built in under 52 months from the time of signing the contract to the time of delivery, Dilbar was also the largest yacht ever to feature a diesel-electric power plant from an engineering standpoint. This lets the 156-meter yacht get up to a cruising speed of 22.5 knots. Her hull and superstructure represented nearly 10,000 square meters of fan surfaces. Dilbar was the worthy winner of the 2017 World Super Yacht Award for Motor Yacht of the Year. The judges praised Dilbar for being arguably the most complex and challenging yacht to ever be built, and the largest ever built in terms of gross tonnage. All aspects of her design and construction were quite superb. The quality construction of her interior, which uses rare materials and striking surface finishes in abundance, is truly spectacular, as is the indoor swimming pool with a capacity of 180 cubic meters, the largest ever installed on a yacht. Dilbar claims another record-breaking feature, a 30,000 kilowatt diesel-electric power plant, thought to be a record for the superyacht, giving her a top speed of 22.5 knots. But the luxury aboard the yacht doesn't stop here. On board, Mr. Usmanov has built a custom Airbus H175 helicopter with interiors by Pegasus Design. The chopper accommodates 7 passengers and features a unique cabin layout with 2 distinct seating areas, a forward zone that provides a lounge atmosphere with facing club seating for 4 passengers and a galley, as well as sofa-style seating that comfortably accommodates 3 passengers at the rear. Ever since her delivery in 2016, Dilbar has drawn the attention of worldwide press as well as social media users around the globe. Her travels through the Mediterranean have hence been essentially documented by enthusiasts around the world, with her photos now having been taken from nearly every possible angle. It's not exactly easy to miss that big of a vessel sailing by, towing other smaller yachts worth a fraction of the price. The latest Dilbar is estimated to be worth is $600 million. As far as the owner of this fantastic vessel, well, he's currently Russia's 5th richest man, with a net worth of $16 billion, according to Forbes. Alisher Usmanov was also featured as one of the most powerful people in the world on their 2016 ranking. Primarily known in yachting through the Dilbar fleet, Usmanov is best known in business circles as the main shareholder of USM Holdings. USM's initial equity stakes primarily stem from metal and industrial sectors. These have, however, over time, diversified and now also include ownership of Megafon, one of Russia's largest telecom operators. To the United Kingdom, Usmanov is best known as one of the co-owners of the Arsenal Football Club. And to the tech community, Usmanov is one of the most successful investors in modern history, having made investments into companies such as Facebook, Alibaba, and Mail.ru. With such an eye for investment, and perhaps an even bigger eye for yachts, it makes me wonder how long do we have until Usmanov sends another paycheck towards his favorite Dutch shipyard requesting a newer, bigger, bolder Dilbar. Well, you can be sure that when that day comes, I'll tell all you kind souls all about it. If you could have a day on the yacht with any celebrity in the world, who would you go yachting with? Let me know in the comment section down below.